I'm a lover of history and all things, especially accordion. Guido Deiro was the guy that brought piano accordion to the United States. Went back in 1909. And that was its first explosion of popularity, was him in vaudeville playing the piano accordion. And of course we all know America, like every country plays a different accordion. America, Canada, we play piano accordion. And it started with Guido. And Joe Cairo, actually when we were at the Dick and Tina Memorial, said, oh, Guido's son is in Vegas. And I'm doing the math in my head, and I'm pretty good at math. And I'm thinking, well, if Guido was born in the 1880s, his son would have been dead a long time ago. So he gave me the number, and I called him, and I actually said, oh, are you Guido's grandson? I said, oh, no, I'm his son. But that's not possible. But he had him so late that, yes. So I went and met him and talked to him about everything about his dad, because this is where it all started. I'm a piano accordion player, of course. And he showed me this accordion. This accordion is the earliest surviving Guido Deiro accordion that he played for many years. It is a 1929, all kinds of customized Guarini accordion for Guido Deiro, even with his name on it, that Guido's son has had. And Guido Jr. is with us tonight. So we're gonna have a lot of history tonight. We're gonna go through Dick and Tino, of course we're gonna do Tony Lovello. But it's going to all be played, most of this concert will be played on this 1929 actual Guido Deiro used accordion that still plays incredibly well. So, I don't wanna think about it too much. It's just the thing, Guido actually played this accordion. This will be a very different concert from a normal Cory concert. So, let me start with a piece by Gus Vizier, who was one of the most important players to me. He was probably the most popular 40s French accordion player. I've only been able to play this accordion maybe an hour and a half ever. It's a little weird because there's only a C marking and then there's an extra row of buttons. So you get lost a little bit. I might need to pull out my GPS at times to find out where in the heck I am on this bass. Ken Seifert is going to be on bass tonight. Rich DeLabio on the drums. This is Bella Cittata for Frank Morocco. Thank you. big song by, I would say, the most innovative jazz accordion player, Tommy Gamina, whose best stuff was with Buddy DeFranco. And my God, was Buddy good. Oh. But I think Buddy sounded the best actually when he played with Tommy. And this is back in the 50s, and they're playing very, very bad stuff back then. So, it's gonna be really interesting on this accordion. Cherokee.
Thank you.
the guy that my dad used to take me to about twice a year, sometimes three times a year. I have to wake up at 5 or 4 in the morning, which I am not good at. I had to wake up at 6:30 this morning to fly out from Texas, so it wasn't that bad. But I did 4 a.m. all the time. We had to drive to New Jersey to see the legend Charlie Nunzio. I was petrified of him, because every mistake, that was an E flat, you know, so you had to go there very prepared. But my favorite tune that he wrote was Bolero Fantasia. I was trying to find the music desperately. I know I have like 4 copies somewhere. So I had to kind of go to YouTube, but I can remember because I did play it a long time ago. And I'd love to do Bolero Fantasia in honor of Charlie Nunzio. Thank you. this is the first time we've probably played together in a long time, but never. So I don't know if we have an honorary woman that can stand at the back if he doesn't play anymore.
Let's see if I can get a note on. Well, the only thing I did is I got him. So, and the talent really doesn't come from me, it comes from my wife who's sitting here.
Tony Dannon. Okay, well, that's Joe's nephew. So I knew Tony Dannon as the judge I was petrified of in every competition, along with Joanne. When I saw that white hair, I was like, I'm dead. I'm so dead. But Tony Dannon was the same. I was petrified. I think one time I got both of them, and I was like, well, that's okay. So Tony Dannon, of course, he could play anything, but I guess he was more known for jazz. And this is his favorite tune, I know, from Joe. But it's also a tune Art Van Damme played many times. So this is really to both of them. And we're going to do it in the style that Tony Dannon normally would play it in. This is All the Things You Want. let me play this accordion. He's here tonight. I'll play a little bit more on it later. He's a big classical fan. And Stas Veselski, where's Stas? Stas is over there. This is the crazed fan who needs to do a selfie right now. I don't know who this man is, security. He'll be on Facebook. That'll be $5, Paul. It'll be $5. Anyway, Guido's a classical fan. So I want to do something kind of straight classical. But of course, being me, Mr. Improviser, I got to do something from Chopin. Because to me, he was the first real jazz pianist and first real improviser. There's so many things he does in his music that clearly show, you know, first time he goes through, second time, it's just little changes of improv. And he, the first chromatic 2-5, if any of the jazz people up here, the first chromatic 2-5 was Chopin in like 1868. And this tune. Guido Deiro actually play on YouTube. So he likely played that tune on this very board. Thank you. I met here in Vegas for the first time when I was about 12 years old. In Milwaukee this year, I play Festa Italiana once in a while. Vicentino played there, I think, 35 times, if I'm not mistaken. Out of the 36 years, I think he only missed 1 year. And they called me and the family and wanted to do a whole show, so we did a Vicentino tribute, and Dick's daughter came and sang. Dick's son came and played drums behind me. And Judy Contino came and sat on the stage, which made me very nervous. Judy Contino is here with us tonight. Thank you, Judy, so much, Tony. We're going to do Arrivederci Roma. Thank you. one, so this is not a good... Because if that was bad, now, to end with, Tony Lovello, another very dear friend. I talked with him a lot, actually, the past couple of years. And there's a CD we're going to do together, because he sent his part. I'm going to be making my part, so we're going to come out with that. And when Tony died, me and Paul were talking about, you know, what different things we play here. It was like, well, to do a tribute to Tony, you kind of have to do that one song where your left arm falls off. Malaguena, that one. So I will preface this by saying, I was doing in Texas, this goes with the Red Bull thing. I play music for the Red Bull Formula One team, because there's a lot of you know. I may be a musician by day, but I'm a racing historian by night. I have many hobbies, that's one of them. So I do a lot of stuff for them. I was with them all week. Probably got 4 hours of sleep every night, I would say somewhere around there. That's good. Three last night, flew here. Trying to get up all the energy, put it together for Tony, and attempt to do his Malaguena. So, here we go. If you notice, my arm is not 6 feet thick like Tony's was. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Cory Pesaturo.
Thank you, Paul. Thank you all very much.